Good day, viewers. You are welcome to another episode of the program Learn Kalabari, brought to you by Kalabari TV. This is a program where we teach the Kalabari language. You can like and follow us on all our social media platforms, and your all-round support is always needed. Previously on our last class, we discussed greetings in Kalabari language. Today, we are going to discuss names of food and names of objects in Kalabari. I am Dokubo Denton. We are starting with the food first. The first food we will discuss today is plantain. Plantain. Now, what is plantain called in Kalabari?
Plantain is called mbana.
Mbana.
The writer of this book, Adebre, spelled it in two ways.
Mbana.
The first spelling or the second spelling, both of them are correct. There's another one. Blood.
Cockle. It's a seafood. And the Kalabari people call it Ofengo.
Ofengo.
This is mostly used in our native soup.
The other we have Cocoyam.
In our Kalabari language, we call this Iku. We use this as a thickener for our native soup.
The next item is Periwinkles. We call periwinkles a
Sam. Like I told you the other time, in our previous class, always take note of these tunal marks. Tunal marks. They are very important. Tunal marks.
We have another one, oyster. Oyster, we call this Ingbe. The writer of this book spelled it in two ways. I'm going to give you all the spellings he gave. Ingbe. The next option is our special Kalabari delicacy.
Special Kalabari. I know some of you are now thinking about it, and I'm sure you know it. Delicacy. This one is called Unu. This is a special Kalabari delicacy made with plantain and yam.
We have another item, pepper soup.
Pepper soup is called Sa ne fo lo. The soup is called Sa ne fo lo.
The We have another one.
Pepe. Pepe is simply Sani. Sani.
We have another one. Beans.
The normal beans we all know. Beans is called okay. Remember your tuna mark? Akedi.
We are going to wipe the board now.
It's already full.
Our next item is soup. Soup is called Folo. That's where the name Sanifolo came about. When they say pepper soup,
they gathered the name for pepper, Sani, and then the name for soup, Folo, together to make it a compound word, and then it is the name of pepper soup, Sanifolo.
We have another one. Gari. Gari is called Otera. Remember your tuna marks? We have another one. Pounded yam. Pounded yam.
Pounded yam. Pounded yam is called buru, otra. You already know what otra is. Pounded yam is called buru otra. Your tuna mask, please. Pounded yam is called buru otra.
Another item is rice. What is rice called?
Rice is simply called Aro. Song. Rice is known as Arosun. Kalabareke Arosun. Rice, sende, Arosun. As a Kalabare person, whenever you see rice, it is named Arosun.
Whenever you see beans,
it is named Akedi.
We have another item, fish. The general name for fish is
Inji. The general name for fish is Inji. Although different species of fish have their different names, but the general name for that creation is Inji.
We have another item, yam.
Yam is called Buru. The B has a tuna mark.
The next on our list is drink.
Drink is simply Iru.
We have water.
Water is simply Minji.
Water is Minji.
We have another item, meat. Meat. I know you're wondering, what is meat called in Kalabari language? Meat is simply Nama. Nama. N-A-M-A. Nama. As simple as that.
Mama. We have goat.
So what is goat meat called?
Goat is called obori. Goat is called obori. If you want to name a meat, goat meat, it is obori nama.
Obori nama.
It's as simple as that. Then chicken is called oboko. Meat is called nama. The next item we have is chicken meat. And the chicken meat is simply oboko nama. So for chicken, we have oboko. We have a buckle number for chicken meats. We're going to wipe the ball straight away. We are now through with common foods. We'll now go to names of objects in Calabari language. Common objects. We're beginning with spoon. Spoon is called okiku. I know so many of you know it as ngaji, but ngaji is not Calabari language. It's a borrowed word from the Igbos. The next we have is knife. Knife is ogie. Another we have is fire. It is known as kore. We have bed, which is called mono ye or e. Bed, what can bed say? Monoye, Anyanya, Ibila. Monoye, Anyanya, Ibila. All is Anyanya in Calabari language. We have another one, Chia. It is known as Da. We have plates. Pani. We have water pot. Known as the cuckoo. This is where we drink water. Our grandmother store water here and then you take it from the village. We have another toilet. This is known as poko. We have another one, latrine. Latrine is.
Beer. Wa. Re. Anyanya. O. Su. Ku.
Kenu. Kenu is.
Ba. Ra. A. Ro.
Bucket.
Bucket is a. Ba. Ku.
We'll get to umbrella. Umbrella. We call it
an be la le. Where this I
as the tuna mark.
This last L has a tuna mark.
Shirt.
It's called kappa. Trousers. O, ko, lo, kappa.
Land.
Kiri.
Grass.
Osu. Ka.
Weed.
Osuwa. Please
always know the difference between Osuka and Osuwa. Weed, Osuwa. Grass, Osuka. They are similar. I want us to take note of something. The Kalabari language is so unique that most of our words as multiple meanings depending on use. We have book as
go diri
and also medicine. Both book
and medicine, they are diri.
We use these suffixes to differentiate them. Go diri, reading book. Budiri, drinking medicine. So when you're using the word diri, try and use it properly. To ascertain the meaning of the message you're passing. Broom. Or
thing.
Bags. Bag.
Bag is akpa.
Aka. The next is Tut. Pick.
Known as Aka. Soki. You.
Toothpick.
Akasoki.
So far, we'll take revisions on what we've learned and then we'll end today's class. We started with common food, which I told you, plantain, isembana.
Revision.
We have a little revision before we go. We learned plantain. As Mbana. The next we add was blood, cockle, which we know as Ofingo. Ofingo. The next we add was cocoyam. That's what we have as Iku. We had the other one, periwinkle. Periwinkle, which we have as
Isan.
Oyster.
We have it as Ingbe.
We have our special Calabari delicacy. We have our Calabari special delicacy
as Onunu.
Went further to pepper soup, where we know it to be as
Sani Folo.
Pepe has
Sani.
The next word was soup.
Fola.
Next was Gary.
Otila.
We went further to
pounded yam, where we had Guru Otera.
Next on our list is rice.
We had a
We went to fish.
Where we said the general name for fish is Ng.
Nji.
We had yam. We said we name for, the name for yam is Buru.
Buru. Buru.
We had drink as you.
That drink went to water.
Water is called Minji.
Meat.
Like we need to be is what? Ma. Ma.
Goat meat. The name for goat is obori. So when they say goat meat, it is simply
obori. Nama. Where now becomes a compound word.
Obori nama. Go to shaking. Chicken meat.
Call it Oboko. Oboko nama.
Chicken is Oboko nama. The last on food is egg.
And egg is Oboko.
This is the last we'll learn. On object, our first item is spoon.
Like I told you, okiko.
Knife.
Ogi.
Fire. Bed.
Ibila. Aneanea. Ibila.
Chia.
Dada.
Plate. Plate is panning. Cooking pot.
Ye. So. Belle.
Kima Max, very important.
Toilet. As poco, rather than a poco.
Latrine. Like I told you,
Biawari. Oh, Anyanya.
Posu. Canoe.
Ba. Ra. Aro.
bucket. Agba. Umbrella. Umbrella as. Ambi. Lali. Shirt. Shirt as kappa. Trousers as okulu kappa. Land as kiri kiri. Grass as osu ka. Weed as osuma. We have book as go diri. Medicine as good diri. We have broom as Ofi Ofiye. We have bag as Akpa.
And the last, toothpick
as aka so ki ye.
This is where we'll end today's class.
Fellow viewers, thank you very much for watching this program. This is where we wrap it up for today's episode. Don't forget to always sponsor Calabari TV for all your updates, and also remember to follow us on all our social media platforms. I am Doc Bodetti. Goodbye.